Hey guys, so I'm sure you've heard of Apple's new line of computers with their new M1 processors, also known as SoC, system on a chip, which means it's a tiny little chip that does the job of an entire computer system. But are they ready to be used by architects and architecture students? This is the very first Mac computer I've purchased. I've always been a PC user. My concern with computers have always been rendering and modeling, and I could never justify paying like double the amount of money for something that worked like more or less the same. But the new M1 processor, that is a bit of a game changer. Well, I got the MacBook Air, and for something so light, beautiful, and sleek, with a 14-hour battery life, it has the equivalent performance of a PC that looks like this.
That is an ugly computer.
So first, this computer costs $1,000 less than your MacBook M1. And all the programs, all your fancy programs, they work here natively, okay? So you don't have any compatibility.
But it's so ugly.
Yeah, it's ugly, but it's works.
Ooh, look at these colorful keyboards.
Get that.
And also with the new processors, the MacBook Pros and the MacBook Airs pretty much have the same performance, except that the Pro has a slightly longer battery life and that it has a fan. But the lack of a fan doesn't even really matter because with these new processors, which are basically like cell phone processors, it consumes such little power that there's basically no need for a fan because it rarely heats up. So it's powerful, it's incredibly light and beautiful, it's silent, it doesn't heat up. It has a 14-hour battery life. It was kind of a no-brainer for me until I started downloading the softwares. So what are the most important softwares for an architect? Probably AutoCAD, Rhino, SketchUp, the Adobe Suites, and Revit. SketchUp works with Rosetta. AutoCAD also works, but with the Rosetta app. Rhino also only works with the Rosetta app. And the Adobe Suites also only works with the Rosetta app. So basically none of these programs are coded for this new ARM architecture. And so you have to download this app called Rosetta that basically runs in the background, and it helps these non-compatible softwares run on the M1. But basically, you're not really taking full advantage of this new super powerful chip. The Adobe Suites do seem to work pretty well on these computers. I've tried opening up a really heavy file and didn't really seem to have any problems. And apparently they are coming up with an update specifically for these M1 chips. I think the Adobe wouldn't be such a huge problem. The Rosetta app, it kind of runs in the background, so it doesn't really impede on the other programs running in your computer. Actually, the biggest problem was with Revit. Revit has never really been compatible with Apple products because it was designed based on PC. But on the previous versions of the Mac, you could use it through Boot Camp, which is basically running Windows on your Mac computer. Or you could create a virtual machine. Parallel is an example, which would let you use Windows instances inside a Mac OS. Or you could do remote login or cloud computing, which is like you access through a browser that's not your machine. And so those were the three different ways you could use Revit on your Mac computer. But with these new chips, it's mostly bad news. On an M1, you don't have boot camp. Like, you can't run Windows on these computers. The virtual machines, they're not possible on ARMs because they're all based on Intel CPUs. The only viable option is using a cloud system. That kind of sucks. The good news is that Autodesk might consider developing a M1 dedicated version of Revit, because not being able to access Revit through Bootcamp will cut out a very large portion of their user base. Before, people were still able to get by using Bootcamp or the virtual machine app. But since this M1 chip is so revolutionary and will probably change the landscape of computers for the next generation, Autodesk might actually consider a new dedicated software for these chips. So my recommendation would be maybe to hold off until the new softwares come out, or if you've already bought it, maybe just hold on to your old computers, whether it's an Intel Mac or a PC, just till this transition period is over. Am I gonna keep my computer? I think I will. I hate myself for paying this much just for the design of it, but really, that is the power of design. Design really sells.